We are here nearly 7 months since the tragic loss of Columbia, and our efforts, the intent of our report, and all of the many hours that we put into this investigation were done to reflect favorably and to reflect with honor on the efforts of the crew, Rick Husband, Willie McCool, Mike Anderson, Dave Brown, Casey Chawla, Laurel Clark, and Elon Ramon. The lives of these people are very precious to us. The board considered that a very serious matter, that these brave people thought that what they were doing was important, that it was significant, that it was part of human space exploration, that the things that were going to be learned from this mission were worth the risk that they were taking. And if this board has any impact whatsoever, we felt that their loss of their lives had better make a difference. Thank you very much. Mr. Hubbard.
Thank you. In four simple words, the foam did it. After a lot of analysis, after a series of tests, we concluded that the falling foam impacting the leading edge of the wing was the cause of the breach that ultimately led to the destruction of the orbiter and the loss of the crew. All of this exhaustive work that we've done, all the discussion and the testing, led us to the simple statement, the foam resulted in the breach that led to the loss of the orbiter.
In our review the following day of the launch films, we saw this piece of debris drop off. It looked to us like it impacted the orbiter on the left wing. Where on the left wing, it's very difficult for us to tell. Somewhere between the mid and outward span. Was it the leading edge? We don't know. Was it underneath the leading edge? We really don't know. We spent a goodly amount of time reviewing that film and then analyzing what that potential impact of debris on the wing might do, and would there be any consequences. Through analysis and through our ability to call back on our experience with tile, it was judged that that event did not represent a safety concern. We were not concerned with Columbia. We felt we had analyzed that, and we felt we understood it such that it was not a thermal concern to us, did not represent a control issue or a safety of flight issue. And I'm going to caution you that that is the case today. We have no information that would say that is not the case.
There was a very strong sense that we knew what happened. We knew that we had some kind of damage on the left main landing gear door. There's no way foam could have damaged the leading edge if it hit it. And those hard over assumptions at the senior level absolutely colored how the rest of the community was pulling data together and pursuing various leads. Now, the two things that changed that, getting the MADS recorder and analyzing that data, and the test at Southwest Research that the CAIB had done, where they actually shot a piece of foam through an actual leading edge or a reinforced carbon-carbon section of leading edge, so exactly like a shuttle leading edge. And when they shot that piece of foam through that leading edge with the same conditions that they expected the foam hit Columbia on STS-107, that changed everything in the minds of those senior leaders.
My personal involvement has been very deeply engaged with the impact testing. I feel that testing accomplished three things. First of all, it corroborated the lines of analysis. Second thing is that, of course, it added to the body of knowledge about this reinforced carbon material. And finally, I think the tests accomplished a third psychological or sociological accomplishment, which is to remove any lingering doubt that indeed this light material could break open the leading edge and could lead to the loss of the orbiter.
We like to use the quote that the foam did it, the institution allowed it. And you can look at whether it's the foam application, foam falling off, the mission management team's conduct, to looking at what happens with a shuttle on orbit, You can look across any of those and you could see where things that were unexpected became expected and then became accepted. Of course, the key one is the foam. Foam falling off of an external tank is unexpected. It's not supposed to happen. Well, it happened, so it came to be expected. And because it was expected, it came to be accepted. And it went on to kill the 7 crew members plus the 2 helicopter crew members that were involved in the debris search. So 9 people died because of that normalization of deviance.
I would say there were 2 causes to the accident. The first cause was the foam. The second was the loss within NASA of its system of checks and balances.